Navy SEAL. From Minnesota. Hollywood.
Jesse, wake up! Get your shit and let's get out of here! The train's leaving for the Caribbean!
What? Hold on, just give me a few minutes. I gotta pack my bag. Okay, Gorilla, I'm ready to go. Gorilla? Gorilla? Did he leave me home alone? Let me call this guy.
Yo!
What the hell? You left me home alone!
I told you the train was leaving. I bet it took you forever to get ready. You weren't even packed yet!
It only took me an hour and a half, 2 hours tops. Who takes a train anymore anyway?
Who takes a train? Price-conscious consumers? People carrying hard drugs? Train-obsessed sociopaths?
Which one are you?
Does it matter? Anyway, I forgot to set up the Christmas episode. Could you do it for me?
What? How am I gonna do that when I'm home alone?
Just cut it out. You know I'm not going to all the trouble to do a Home Alone parody with all the traps and stunts and bullshit.
Okay.
Just host the episode for me, okay?
All right. I'll do it, but what happens if I...
Thanks, bye, Merry Christmas!
How rude. Anyway, it's the Christmas episode, I guess. Raz Holly, hit the music!
Christmas. It's a time for family get-togethers, special events, and toys. You might not think it, but take a look around your Christmas decorations and you'll find toys. Ornaments on the tree? Those nutcrackers are toys for sure. And how about the nativity? It's practically a figure playset. It's got figures, accessories, and a little facade. If this thing isn't a playset, I don't know what is. Anyway, if you didn't already know, the Nativity depicts the birth of Jesus Christ, central figure in the Christian religion. The Nativity typically contains figures of Mary, Joseph, and the baby Jesus, Natch. But you can also get a shepherd, an angel, three wise men, or kings bearing gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. There can also be animals, a little half barn, and other accessories too. I know what you're saying. Dan, this isn't toys, it's Christmas decorations. Oh yeah? Well, I've got three words for you. Playmobil Nativity Set. Playmobil makes all kinds of stuff. This isn't even close to being the wackiest. In fact, the Nativity as a Playmobil playset makes a lot of sense. Figures, accessories, and a little building facade? That's a playset, and we're gonna take a look at it right now.
Okay, so here it is. It's Playmobil's Nativity Set. This is from, I believe, about 1999, so not as old as stuff we usually see around here, but definitely technically vintage at this point in time. You have this watercolored background that's made out of a hard paper stock. You fold it up together and you create this nice little diorama, and it contains all of everything you see here. I'm only missing one piece to this, and if you believe it, I got this thing $3. $3 I got this for, and won it on an auction on eBay. I would have been stupid not to buy it. I do have a modern one that's got a light up star on the top here. My star doesn't light up. It is just a watercolor painting or whatever. But all in all, this actually works pretty good as a nativity as well as a playset, because you've got all the characters here. The only thing that's missing that you might want to have in here are the three kings. There are no three kings. That is a separate set. That was a separate set back in the day. It's a separate set now. I was gonna buy them for the review, but it was like $30, and I figure you know what? I got this thing for $3. There's three kings. I'll just show you a picture of the three kings. Here it is. Excellent. Now, let's take a look at what we do have on this set, because we have everything except for one piece. And the only thing I'm missing is the angel's wings. So let's start with the angel. The angel's actually a little smaller than everybody else. It's like a child angel. And doesn't have her little wing set, but she does have the halo that comes on and off. You can put it on all the other characters if you want to. And her magic angel wand. Yeah, that's canon. Anyway, also, what else do we have here? We have the shepherd. The shepherd, he has a nice green cape and he's a hobo stick. His bindle, if you will, with his hobo bag on there, and his nice little headband as well, and a gray beard, very Bible-y looking. The shepherd would be what without his sheep? You got a big sheep, you got a couple little sheeps, and you got a goat to go with them. Oops, sorry about that. Yeah, and everything falls over because this thing is 20 years old, and the ground is sort of warped. So, yeah, I'm going to knock shit over when I take it out of there. But I wanted to get back here and show you the rest of the animals we had here. We have a bull. That's pretty cool. And we also have a donkey with a saddle on him. I don't know why. We got a donkey on a saddle. Maybe it's Mary and Joseph's saddle. We have an accident here. I don't know. We have things like this wood, and I guess it's supposed to go, according to the box, the wood here is supposed to go in this basket, and the basket goes on top of the thing, and you have a couple kitties. You have a couple little kitties. You have this kitty and this kitty, and one of them was in the basket. One of them's supposed to be out here in the front or whatever, but I guess you can kind of do whatever you want with them. Also, have you got kind of a cooking area here with a pot, and it looks like somebody replaced the little chain once upon a time, because it did come with what looks like a different chain, and it's been replaced. But this is pretty much the entire set, and let's get to the main event. The main event, we got Jesus, Mary, and Joseph right here, front and center. Let's take a look at Joseph first. He has a lantern, he has his little hippie headband, and his beard and long hair get up. Yeah, that's, you know, I mean, by himself, do you say that's Joseph?
I don't know!
But yeah, you probably know who this is supposed to be, or you'd be like, is that Mary? Yes, it is. And yeah, there she is. It's Mary. It's Virgin Mary in Playmobil form. If you thought, you know, if it couldn't get any friggin' weirder, there it is. It's Virgin Mary in Playmobil form. And then finally, the main event, it's the baby Jesus! And here he is. He's a baby. He's Jesus. He has a part in his hair. He has a full head of hair, like a newscaster from the 1970s. Look at the do on baby Jesus. He also has a little white jumpsuit on. As you do. Maybe he's supposed to be swaddled, but then why are his arms bare? Bare arms. Laying in the nice little stand here, baby stand you've got him in. And this is pretty much it. This works as a playset. This works as a nativity. You could put this up on your shelf during the holidays if you wanted to. If you're a freaking toy freak like myself, this wouldn't look out of place. You put this out for the holidays or whatever as a decoration, and it's compatible with all your other Playmobil stuff. You could put Jesus and Mary and Joseph in Ecto-1, load them up, have them fighting ghosts, have them in the Back to the Future car, all that good shit. So here it is. It's the Playmobil Nativity.
Well, that's the Christmas episode, I guess. What did you think of that Playmobil stuff? Personally, I think Playmobil's for babies, but whatever. Anyway, happy holidays, Merry Christmas, Happy Hanukkah, or whatever you and yours celebrate. We'll see you next time on the Dan Classic Show. Raz Holly, hit the music!